Yeah, I'm Matthew Kingpin. Welcome to a series I like to call Comfort Characters, in which I express my immense adoration for various fictional people in video games, including discussing the aspects of those characters that I feel get largely overlooked or are unfairly criticized. In this episode, I want to talk about Roman, a character from This War of Mine, a game I've talked about in a more long-form essay format style previously on this channel, and why his story and the way he is written and programmed make me more attached to him than any other member of the cast. Roman's story is one that I find myself really resonating with and respecting, and I'd like to share and explain that love with this video through talking about his backstory, his hidden virtuousness, and his unique mechanical complexity that further adds credence that there's more going on with Roman beneath their bitter exterior. Though before I start, content warning, Roman is a former soldier, so I will be talking about war and war crimes alongside trauma and PTSD. So if you don't want to hear about this, please consider skipping ahead to the concluding thoughts portion of the video, which will be clean. Aside from all that, shall we get started? A cold and ruthless exterior, a front face that gives off an impression that any shred of care left in them was cast aside far prior. But is that exterior the truth? Roman's story originates with him as an operative of the very same military faction that the rest of the cast is oppressed by and made into refugees because of. They're the only character in the game actively trained in combat, and also one of only a select handful of characters that are outright amoral, with neither acts of kindness nor acts of malice causing noticeable changes to Roman's mood or outlook, at least on the surface. A further exploration of Roman's backstory paints him in a much more virtuous light as each piece of his lore is revealed to the player, showing that while he was and still is someone who loves the thrill of the fight and someone whose callousness prolifically exudes from his being through even the chilling side-eyed stare he shoots towards the camera in his photo, he's not a monster. In fact, he's not a monster to the point where he chose to invite great personal risk unto himself in the service of not being complicit in the worst atrocities of his rebel brothers, and in some cases, lifelong friends. Every survivor in This War of Mine is a potential casualty, one fired bullet from a trigger-happy militia member away from having the story of their struggle end right then and there. But Roman, he's a deserter, an act met with harsh punishments even in an organized government armed force, let alone the ruthless soldiers inciting This War of Mine's conflict. Roman, by choosing to uphold his moral code, doesn't just make himself a civilian, but a high-value target to his former allies. While he may be a bit of a jackass, a self-centered punk, and extremely jaded, through choosing to invite so much life-threatening risk unto his person by willing to become one of the very individuals his former faction are oppressing, murdering, and committing atrocities upon, he shows the actual depth of his moral character. Choosing to do the right thing is much more difficult when you have a lot more to potentially lose in its pursuit. When you have power, it is hard to relinquish that power. Even within the mechanics of how that moral character is programmed as a gameplay element paint a far more vulnerable and human light than Roman's frightening visage might otherwise indicate. Trauma affects us all differently. Some of us are more sensitive, more susceptible to its soul-rending potential outcomes and disorders, and at times, others are more resilient to being made broken by the terrible occurrences that fate undesirably bestows upon them. A specific mechanic in This War of Mine explores this idea through a changing of a character's outlook and personality with enough traumatic events occurring to them or their fellow survivors within the game. A caring and altruistic individual may become more distant and hopeless if that selflessness is met with tragedy after tragedy, for example. Unfortunately, many people are forever changed by their trauma, and seldom few come out of impossibly dark situations as better people. With how battle-hardened and gruff Roman's outward disposition is, though, with how unemotionally he reacts to the horrible injustices that your own group of survivors can commit in their desperation to continue living another day, you would think Roman would similarly also have a high tolerance for hardship and tragedies. As stated before, however, a superficial glance of his character does not accurately represent his underlying feelings, and in this case, his underlying fragility. In terms of raw gameplay mechanics, every character in This War of Mine has a hidden value of how many terrible acts their psyche can endure before they break, and permanently switch their personality type from their regular variant to their traumatized one. Roman's a special case when it comes to this specific mechanic, however, as he requires the fewest amount of atrocities to be committed upon him and his fellow survivors out of the whole cast before he is permanently broken and traumatized forever. As much as he wants everyone to believe that he's glacially dispositioned, jaded, and uncaring, he's in reality just one final injustice away from throwing away his humanity, his dignity, and his morality, and becoming the very same type of person he found abhorrent enough to paint a massive target on his own back just to get away from. He is a very rough around the edges individual. Hell, he's nothing but a lot of edges in a lot of cases. But underneath that barbed wire laden front face lies someone who does care about the well-being of others and wants to try to do the right thing, even despite that obstinate outwardness. But everyone has a breaking point, and Roman starts his journey far closer to that terminus than anyone else. That's why I love him so much as a fictional character. His personality and his struggle feel so vividly real. He's capable of committing the worst atrocities out of any member of the cast, single-handedly clearing entire locations and outposts and murdering every civilian he sees with ease, yet he actively chooses not to do so, as long as the war in Porygen doesn't force him across that line. And as a player, I find a wealth of comfort in helping him not cross that line. Roman deserves a happy ending. I want to help him live long enough, both physically and morally, to see it. That's about all I have to say for this production. This video wasn't too lengthy, I know, but I'm essentially testing out a proof of concept, alongside converting a lot of usable footage and some of my internal thoughts and fixation into an actual consumable format that other people can enjoy. I have many comfort characters from throughout the many years I've played video games and escaped into media and art from a real life that gave me more than enough reasons to desire to do so. People are my reason to be, whether they live and breathe or beep and boop, real or a creation of another. So, I'll probably make more of these. Not everything on this channel should be quite so miserable after all, huh? There are some things about this world to love and appreciate, even if they're arguably, solidly, not the majority. As always, please allow me your thoughts, your discussions, your feedback in the comments section below. I want to hear all about everything you liked or anything this video made you feel something about. I love to hear about how other people react to my version of reality. It truly does make the process I go through to make these productions all the more special. The other usual methods of helping the channel be seen by other people are appreciated as well, you know the ones, every YouTuber says them at the end of every video. Those clicks slash button presses help me out more than you know. Outside of that, please join the Discord server linked in the description to keep yourself aware of any new videos I make. They're posted about in the new uploads channel every single time I produce one. Subscribing, while appreciated, will not cause my videos to show up in your feed thanks to YouTube's system, unfortunately. Outside of all that, burn your dread, go into the future, and I'll meet you there. But
still fire.
Oh, I missed that horribly. One Tetris. Yeah, they're already out of it. No, why did that miss? Nice shot. Holy ace? Don't call it an ace.
Call it a comeback, kid.
Oh my gosh. You got it.